Good morning, children. In our previous class, we have read about food and health. Yesterday, we read about it, how food is related to our health. Just recall what you have read yesterday. We all know food gives us what? Energy. And there are different types of nutrients present in food items that are required for our proper growth and development of our body. And this is healthy eating pyramid, what you have drawn yesterday in your homework, which items we should eat the most is here at the bottom. Then which food items we should eat more, that is fruits and vegetables, that is here on second step. Then we should eat moderately, neither too much nor too less, milk and dairy products. Then which items we should eat less, fat, salt and sugar. We should take such type of diet which should be balanced in every, with respect of every nutrients. Means we should take such type of diet in which carbohydrates should be there, because carbohydrates give us energy. Protein should be there, fat should be there, vitamins should be there and minerals should be there. And the diet which contains all these things are known as balanced diet. So children, every day you have to take balanced diet to make you stronger. If you are stronger, if you are very strong, then only coronavirus cannot affect you. So eat always balanced diet. Now we have read about health also. Then we read about diseases. There are two types of diseases, non-communicable and communicable. About it I told you, communicable disease, highly communicable disease, coronavirus, what we are suffering these days. Now today we have to start in detail from non-communicable diseases. Communication means what? Transfer. Then here diseases which generally do not get transmitted. Here in this spelling you see children, T-R-A-N-M-I-T-T-E-D written. Here S is missing. So all of you make this correction in your book, that you write here T-R-A-N-S-M-I-T-T-E-D. Transmitted from one person to another are called non-communicable diseases. Means the disease which cannot communicate it, cannot be communicated from one person to another, cannot be transferred from one person to another. They are known as non-communicable diseases. Here again you see what is written. Diseases which generally do not get transmitted from one person to another are called non-communicable diseases. While some of these diseases may be present at birth, maybe due to the lack of some nutrients, some diseases may be present at birth. A number of them are caused due to deficiency. Deficiency means if we take those nutrients in less amount, or lack of some particular nutrient, such as those nutrients are proteins, then carbohydrates, vitamins or minerals in our diet. That's why we should take which type of diet? Balanced diet. And these non-communicable diseases are also called deficiency diseases. Deficiency diseases means they are due to the lack of some nutrients, due to the deficit of some nutrients. That's why they are called deficiency diseases. Diseases that are caused due to some deficiency, some lack, which is in less in amount in our diet, are known as deficiency diseases. Now we will see what are the different types of deficiency diseases and they are caused due to what. First one is protein carbohydrate deficiency disease. Here you see two pictures are there of two kids. One is very healthy, happy, and the another one is weak child. Now children, you tell me which child you like. Of course, healthy child. The child who is healthy is happy. But you see this child who is a weak child, he is unhappy. So why this child is unhappy? Because he is lacking some deficiency. He is suffering with some deficiency diseases due to the lack of protein and carbohydrate. Here you see protein is a bodybuilding nutrient. Means protein help us to make our body strong, to repair our worn out tissues. And carbohydrate is an energy giving nutrient in our body. Means carbohydrate gives us energy and protein makes our body strong. Here you see this child is strong, that's why he is energetic. This child is weak, that's why he is not energetic. So this child is suffering with protein and carbohydrate deficiency disease. Now look carefully at the picture given above. Here it is given, the child shown in the picture 1. This is picture 1. You see, this child looks healthy and active, while the child in picture 2, this is picture 2. You see this child, I have shown you now only. This child shown in picture 2 is suffering from lack of proteins and carbohydrates in his diet. Means no protein is there, that's why body is not made strong. No carbohydrate is there, that's why energy is not there in him. So he is suffering with lack of protein and carbohydrates in his diet. Here in this table you see the following table lists the main symptoms of protein carbohydrate deficiency. If there is a deficiency, deficiency means what? Less. If when the protein or carbohydrate or any nutrient is present in less amount. So if protein and carbohydrate is less in your body, then which symptoms the person can suffer? First symptom is improper growth of the body. Body will not grow healthy. Growth will be hampered. That is first symptom. Then second is loose skin. Skin will not be tightened. It will loose. And sunken eyes, what we have seen in the above picture. Then thin and light hair. Hair quality will also be very thin and light. Then person is inactive and gets tired easily. Person will not be active and very soon he can get tired. So if a person is suffering with protein and carbohydrates deficiency in his diet, then which symptoms he may suffer? Improper growth of the body, loose skin and sunken eyes, thin and light hair, and person is inactive and gets tired very easily. Your homework is today, whatever these charts are given, that you have to draw it in your science notebook and then you will submit it on our WhatsApp group. Here many charts are given in this lesson. First chart is this. So remember this chart also you have to make. Then in the next pages we will read the other charts also. That also you have to make. Here you see children in the age group of 6 months to 3 years. What is the age group? 6 months to 3 years often suffer from this type of deficiency disease if they do not get a proper balanced diet. Means after 6 months, a child, if he doesn't get a proper balanced diet, then he may suffer with this protein and carbohydrate deficiency diseases. And mostly the children in the age group of 6 months to 3 years suffer with that. Now second is mineral deficiency diseases. Means if any mineral is lacking in the diet, then the person may suffer from different types of diseases. This is mineral deficiency diseases. Minerals. What are the minerals? Calcium, phosphorus, iron, iodine and sodium. These are the minerals and these are present in our body in small amounts, but it is necessary to be in our body. Deficiency of different minerals in our body leads to improper functioning of different parts of the body. If minerals are lacking in our body, then our body parts will not function properly. It will function improperly. Here in this table you see, this table also you have to make. One table, in that I have told you protein and carbohydrate deficiency. Second is this mineral deficiency diseases. This is also your homework. This also you have to make it in your science notebook and then you will submit it on our WhatsApp group. Here one by one we will see what are the minerals, which type of deficiency diseases can cause and what are the symptoms of that disease. First mineral we will read about, iron. Due to the lack of iron, which disease will be there? Anemia. Anemia means lacking of iron, less hemoglobin content in blood. Now what are the symptoms? If a person is suffering with anemia or in his diet iron is lacking, then what are the symptoms of the disease? A person looks weak and pale. Weak means he will not be strong. Pale means yellowish skin. Gets tired very easily. Person can get tired very easily without any work. And is prone to different infections. Means he may got any type of different types of infections can affect his body if iron is lacking in his diet. Now second mineral is calcium and phosphorus. And if calcium and phosphorus is less in anyone's diet, then what are the symptoms he or she may feel? Weak teeth. Our teeth will be, calcium is very important for our teeth. Weak teeth lose their shine and whiteness. Means there will be no whiteness in our teeth. There will be no shine in our teeth. Our teeth will not be strong if calcium is not, calcium and phosphorus is not in our diet. Weak means not strong. Soft means not enough strong or hard. And fragile bones. Fragile means which can be easily broken. Means our bones can be easily broken. If calcium and phosphorus minerals are not in our diet. So calcium and phosphorus is important for what? For our teeth and for our bones. Because without them, without calcium and phosphorus, our teeth will lose their shine and whiteness. They will become weak also. And our bones will also become weak, soft and fragile, which can be easily broken. Then next one is iodine. Iodine salt. On television you must have seen the advertisement of iodine salt. Due to the lack of iodine, what will be there? Which disease is goiter? Which type of disease is goiter? Enlargement of glands in neck. In neck, glands will be enlarged. Here you see in the neck. This lady is suffering with goiter. Enlargement of glands in neck. And what are the symptoms of this? Swelling in the neck region. Here you see. Swelling is, are you able to see this swelling in the neck? This is due to which disease? Goiter. Goiter is caused due to lack of which mineral? Iodine. Then retarded growth means growth will be hampered, stopped. Then mental disorder means mental condition of the person will also be not fit. If a person is suffering with goiter, and goiter, if in his diet iodine is lacking, then person may suffer with goiter. Herein, do you know, you see, due to the lack of iron, anemia disease occur, and that is less hemoglobin content in the blood. Now, what is hemoglobin? Hemoglobin is a pigment found in blood which transports oxygen and provides red color to blood. What is the color of the blood? Red. This red color is due to what? Hemoglobin. And hemoglobin transports oxygen also in the blood. Now, third one is vitamin deficiency. Two tables I have shown you that you have to draw in homework. This is the third table. This also you have to draw it in your science notebook, and this is also your homework. Due to the lack of vitamin, which type of diseases can be occurred? In class 4, you have already learned about the types of vitamins, their functions and sources. Now in this table you see different types of vitamins, deficiency diseases and their symptoms. First one is vitamin A. If in our diet vitamin A is not there, then which type of diseases will be there? Night blindness. What are the symptoms? Unable to see in dim light. Means if light is less, then the person will not see anything. Dullness in eyes. Eyes will look dull. Then the skin will be dry and scaly. That is due to the lack of which vitamin? A. And what is the disease called? Night blindness. Now come to vitamin B. Due to the lack of vitamin B, which deficiency disease will be caused? Beriberi. And what are the symptoms of beriberi? Extreme weakness. If a person is suffering with beriberi, then extreme weakness he may feel. Then paralysis of body parts. Paralysis means you must be knowing. If one part of body stops working, that is called paralysis. So if vitamin B is not there in the diet, then the disease will be beriberi, and in beriberi the symptoms are extreme weakness and paralysis of body parts. Now third vitamin is C. Due to the deficiency of vitamin C, scurvy, this disease caused. And what are the symptoms of this disease? Swollen and bleeding gums. Blood will come out from your gums. Then teeth will be loose teeth, and in joints pain will be there. That is due to what? The lack of vitamin C. Which disease? Scurvy. Now next vitamin is vitamin D. Due to the lack of vitamin D, yesterday also I told, which disease is caused? Rickets. In rickets disease, what happens? Soft and weak bones, bow-shaped legs. Bones will be very soft, and if bones will be soft and weak, then what will be there? They may be broken very easily, and the legs will be bow-shaped. Here you see the legs of this boy. He is suffering with rickets, and this is only bow-shaped legs. The leg of this boy is O-shaped and scurvy. Blood is coming from the gums. So these three charts I have told you children. What is your homework today? Protein and carbohydrate diseases, then minerals and then vitamins. Those three charts, you have to draw it in your science notebook and submit it on our WhatsApp group. In Do You Know You See It is written, in 1910, an American scientist found that the outer layer of rice kernel contains a substance called thiamine. Outer layer of rice kernel contains a substance. Which substance it contains? Thiamine. This is needed by the body to prevent a disease called beriberi. And this substance, thiamine, prevent which disease? Beriberi. And this substance also called vitamin B. And it was the first vitamin to be discovered. Which vitamin was first of all discovered? Vitamin B. So that's all for today. This prevention of deficiency diseases we will see in our next class. Today homework I have already told you. You have to draw those three tables where the diseases are written, minerals are written, vitamins are written and protein and carbohydrate deficiency diseases and its symptoms are written. So that's all for today. Goodbye.